This circuit includes a rubber spatula. Do you think the bulb will glow? No, the bulb doesn't glow. Let's replace the rubber spatula with a silver spoon and see if the bulb will glow now. Yes, it does. Why did the bulb glow the second time, and why didn't it earlier? The rubber spatula is a bad conductor. But silver spoon is a good conductor. Good conductors have lower resistance, and the current passing through the circuit will be more. Comparatively, bad conductors have more resistance, and the current passing through the circuit will be much less. So now, can you explain what resistance is, and what the factors that affect the resistance of any material are? Here you see one bulb connected to this electric cell. Note the brightness of the bulb. Let us connect a second bulb in a series to the same electric cell. Both the bulbs are glowing, but they are dimmer. Why is this so? This is so because the resistance of the two bulbs together is more than that of the single bulb. Let's see what happens if the bulbs are connected in parallel. As you can see, the bulbs glow with the same brightness. In a parallel connection, all the bulbs get the same voltage. According to Ohm's law, the resistance of a circuit is the ratio between the voltage of that circuit and the current that flows through it. Can you explain the relationship between resistance on the one hand and the bulbs being connected in series or in parallel? When two or more bulbs are connected in series, resistance increases and the flow of the current decreases. This makes the bulbs glow dimmer. But when the bulbs are connected in parallel, resistance decreases and the flow of current is not affected. This makes both the bulbs glow at the same intensity. The unit of resistance is ohm. The resistance of a conductor is said to be 1 ohm if a current of 1 ampere flows through a circuit which is at a potential difference of 1 volt. There are 4 factors affecting the resistance of a conductor. The material of the conductor, the length of the conductor, the thickness of the conductor, and its temperature. Resistance R is directly proportional to length L of the conductor or wire. In other words, the longer the wire, its resistance is greater. Resistance R inversely proportional to the thickness of the wire A, where A is the area of the wire's cross-section. In other words, the thicker the wire, the lesser the resistance. So, R equals rho L by A, where rho is a constant called resistivity, or specific resistance of the material of the wire. Let's actually measure the resistance of a bulb filament to understand how resistance is calculated. Find the resistance offered by the filament of a bulb whose current is measured as 4 amperes. An electric cell connected to this bulb has a potential difference of 12 volts. by applying the formula for resistance, R equals V divided by I, and substituting the values for V and I, we get the resistance of the filament of the bulb as 3 ohms.